Hi there! Today we are gonna dive into the incredible story of Jim Simons, a mathematician who managed to turn his numerical skills into billions of dollars, without any fancy business idea or financial background. If you have a talent for mathematics and have thought about entering the finance world, well, this story is for you. Now, when we talk about the equation mathematics equals money, Jim Simons is surely the very first person who comes to mind. He's got it all, a degree from MIT, a PhD in mathematics, and even a Veblen Prize, which is like the holy grail of math acknowledgements. He even worked as a secret code breaker during the Cold War. So he really ticked all the boxes of a math genius. But here is the real mind-blowing part. Forbes magazine estimates his fortune at $14 billion, making him the most successful hedge fund manager in history. His investment company, Renaissance Technologies, has the best track record ever on Wall Street, with a return before fees of more than 66% each year over 30 years. Even during the market apocalypse of 2008, Simons funds score an insane gain of 98%. So how did Simons and his crew achieve such an unprecedented success? Well, Renaissance Technologies is like a secret society, and has always been very discreet when it comes to their trading strategies. But for what we know, its success boils down to few points: algorithmic trading, automation, and a strict risk management. Algorithmic trading is about using advanced mathematical models to execute trades. Now, when Gene Simon started working in finance back in the 80s, the trading floors were full of people who did not understand much about numbers. At the time, everybody believed that beating the market was just a matter of guts and intuition. But Simons realized that financial time series are, in fact, full of hidden patterns and anomalies that could be easily revealed by using mathematical models. For example, one of the most successful trading strategies developed by Simons was based on reversion prediction. The idea behind reversion prediction is that prices are not completely random, but always follow some trend. So if there is a deviation very far from this trend, the price will tend to reverse its direction, back to the trend. If a price is unusually high, then it's time to sell before it crashes. On the other side, if you spot a dirt cheap asset, that's the moment to buy. It's all about identifying these baseline trends. Most of the time, these price fluctuations are tiny, and intuition alone is not enough. And that's when you start needing some serious math. Okay, next, let's talk about the power of automation. To spot these market fluctuations, we need data and computational resources. Computerizing trading systems has many benefits: speed, possibility to handle a huge amount of trading, and last but not least, automated trading systems leave emotions and gut feelings out of the equation. Automation has taken trading to a new level with high-frequency trading, where computers are directly connected to stock exchanges and other trading platforms. This enables real-time analysis of market data and identification of potential trading opportunities almost instantaneously. With a powerful computer, hundreds of trades can be executed in a fraction of a second. In the end, it's about focusing on many small but secure trades rather than relying on a few high-risk opportunities. And here is the last variable of this equation of success: risk management. Simons and his team have always prioritized extraordinary risk controls, portfolio diversification, and constant monitoring of market conditions. Simons once admitted that their trading strategies were only right about 50.7% of the time. That's slightly more often than flipping a coin. Now, that might sound underwhelming, but here is the kicker. When your model can guarantee that you are always right 50.7% of the time, well, then your gains might not be astronomical, but they are pretty reliable. So, by consistently being on the winning side, even if it's by a small margin, they could grow their fortunes over time. Renaissance Technology was the first hedge fund that began hiring only math experts, very often without any financial background. And thanks to the ever more complex models developed by these mathematicians, Simons managed to stay on top of the game for decades. He hired some Tier 1 mathematicians and a lot of Tier 2 mathematicians. Well, other quants funds have mostly tier 3 mathematicians, or even worse, they don't even know that these tiers exist. But what do you think? Have you ever considered applying your scientific skills to the world of finance? I'd love to hear your stories, insights, and any lessons you've learned along the way. Let me know what you think by writing your comments below. And in the meanwhile, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.